Ecosystem. You may be wondering what an ecosystem is. Well, an ecosystem is a group of organisms and their non-living surroundings. So in this ecosystem, there's the foxes, the squirrels, the trees, the plants, the birds, and the rabbits. And the non-living surroundings would be like the gravel, the water, and the air. Now, the animals or organisms inside of that ecosystem interact with each other normally by eating each other. A way you can represent this is through food chains or through food webs. Now, they're different, so I'm going to explain that. Now, a food chain is a part of a food web, and it's where each animal depends on the other one for food. So this one, the gazelle depends on the grass for food, the cheetah depends on the gazelle for food, and the lion depends on the cheetah for food. Now, this is a food chain, and if you go back to the food chain, you can see that this food chain is inside of this food web. Now, you can see that there's four levels. There's the producers, the primary consumers, the secondary consumers, and the tertiary consumers. Now, the producers produce their own food, and then the primary consumers depend on them for food, and then the secondary consumers depend on the primary consumers for food, and then eventually the line depends on everything else for food. Now, you can see that here the lion, the cheetah, the zebra, and the tree can be made into a food chain like this one. So now here at the forest ecosystem, there's also a food web here, and there's also food chains. Now one of the food chains is the rabbit gets eaten by the fox, and the fox gets eaten by the bird. Now, if the rabbit just happens to disappear, then the fox couldn't get food by the rabbit, which means it would starve and it would disappear, which means the bird couldn't eat the fox, which means the bird would disappear. Now that's a lot of the animals in the ecosystem gone just because the rabbits disappeared. Now that can show you how one little part of the ecosystem can affect the whole ecosystem. Now, just remember, an ecosystem is a community of organisms and their environment. And so a food web is an ecosystem's organisms and how they interact. And a food chain is just a part of that food web. So producers make their own food, and consumers eat the producers or other consumers. The producer is the first level of the food web. The primary consumer is the second level of the food web. The secondary consumers are the third level of the food web, and the tertiary consumers are the fourth level or of the food web, or it could be higher. Now, if one part of a food web or food chain or an ecosystem goes extinct, remember that could affect the whole ecosystem. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Fun with Science.